He's been awarded, gossiped about and accused. But after 40 years in the public eye, Paul Hogan has decided to go back to his roots. He is bringing a brand new stage show to town from November called An Evening with Hoges, where he'll discuss everything from some taxing times to plastic surgery to just how he made it from the Harbour Bridge to Hollywood. There's never been a career like it, from rigger on the Sydney Harbour Bridge to movie star.
What memories do you have when you look over at the old coat hanger there?
My memories, regrets.
Regrets? Mm. You have a few?
I've had a few. But then again, too few to mention.
You're a poet.
I did what I had to do.
But they might get a mention when he takes to the stage in November for a national tour called An Evening with Hoges.
It's the payback tour.
Payback? In what way?
Well, the viewers gave me the life I have, so I'm sharing it with them. What I'm doing is that it's all true, which is unusual for me because, you know, I usually make stuff up. And it's, you know, truth is stranger than fiction. It's sort of the life I've had.
At 73, Paul Hogan says he has plenty to be proud of and insists doing this tour is not about rehabilitating his image.
I'm not worried about what my image is. You know, all that tax stuff. Crap. It is what it is. Nothing and rubbish. But it's getting back to doing what I do and like to do.
Are there things about your career that you think most Australians are unaware of?
Oh, yeah.
Like what?
Oh, well, if I tell you now, then I've got no material left. But well, a lot of the things I've done and the television shows and special events and movies and things, there are stories that go with them. Nothing just happens automatically. Where do they come from? And sometimes the story for something existing is funnier than what you saw on the screen. So it's just a night of laughter.
You got a light, buddy?
Yeah, sure, kid. There you go.
And your wallet.
Nick, give him your wallet.
What for?
He's got a knife.
Knife. That's a knife.
When you make a movie as successful as Crocodile Dundee, with a budget as small as it was, traditionally Hollywood leaps on you because they see you as their ticket to new money-making ventures. What sort of things were thrown at you in the wake of the success of that movie?
Oh, everything that was floating around. You become flavour of the month for flavour of the 6 months, or maybe even the year. And everything's thrown at you, good, bad and otherwise. And then as you knock everything back, so, no, I never set out to be an actor. I like to do comedy and I like to do my own comedy. The next movie I'm doing, I'll write that, thank you. Then once that gets around, then the quality of what you're being offered starts to deteriorate, so that you're getting scripts that Jean-Claude Van Damme or Steven Seagal or one of those other horrible people knock back. You know, you really see some rubbish. But, you know, I wasn't interested anyway. So.
Did you really turn down the lead role in Ghost?
That's the one that I miscalculated.
So you did?
Yeah. And it's weird because I wrote my movie and I had Patrick Swayze lined up for it, not on the dotted line, but through a conversation. And then I got offered Ghost and I read it, and it was directed by one of the Zucker brothers who did that zany, you know, airport sort of comedy. And I read it and thought, oh, that's not very funny. No. And then I was ready to go and Patrick rang up and said, oh, look, I've taken the lead in this other movie. Oh, it's a Ghost. So he made the wiser decision.
Would you have been all right with the pot? How are you with pottery? Would you have been able to nail that?
Oh, you had to nail that, yeah. Oh, it was a lovely movie.
It was. But,
I'd read it as a Zucker Brothers comedy, and it's not funny. You know. But, you know, that's, I don't really regret it. I think it was would have been nice. I think it was a cool movie.
Tell me what it was like the year you hosted the Oscars.
Oh, I just went on and talked like I was a punter at home watching it and telling them, this is how you do it. And it was lovely because there was no script, and I didn't rehearse, and I didn't have to, and I had no auto cue. I was maybe the only person ever to open the Oscars in the last 50 years without auto cue.
You look absolutely incredible. What's your fitness regime? You know, what do you do to keep fit?
I row a lot.
You row?
Yeah, because I got into kayaking, depending on which country you're in.
Yeah.
So I use a rowing machine. And yeah, my skin's got old.
Has it?
I'm a little wrinkly and saggy, but the rest of me's like, feels like I'm still 40.
I guess all those years on the bridge in the sun, you weren't slip, slop, slapping.
My plastic surgery, which I've... people like saying that just so they can say, you should get your money back, Hoges. Plastic surgery for me has been a bit out of that ear, two bits out of that ear, two bits out of here, about seven bits out of my shoulders, and sort of...
skin cancers.
Yeah. Well, when I was a kid, you sort of put bacon oil on or something, or nothing in the sun, and it was called a healthy tan. So, you know, and then when you get older, you've got, oh, geez, hang on a minute, there's bits dropping off everywhere.
You can watch Crocodile Dundee today and it still stands up. Sure, the fashions are a bit different, but the humour, the story, it's still funny. It still resonates.
You know, it's the most relicensed movie of all time in America.
I did not.
Yeah, it's just been renewed for another 7 showings or something.
So that backs up what I just said.
Nearly 30 years. Yeah, yeah.
Do you think many comedies today are likely to have that sort of longevity?
No, well, The Hangover won't be... no one will be watching The Hangover in... funny and all as it was, they won't be watching it in 20 years.
No. Why?
Oh, it won't hold. There's nothing else in it. It's sort of shallow. You know what I mean? It's just bang, 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 laugh. It hasn't got any heart.
And he won't be heading back up the bridge anytime soon.
You're never going to do the bridge club?
Yeah, pay to go up there and be chained to a mob of galahs and sort of... no, I don't think so.
Not going to happen.
No.
Some nitwits put 2 dunnies in here.
One dunny, one bidet.
Bidet?
It's for, after you know. You figure it out. See you at 7.
Yeah.
Angela Bishop, 10 News.